I wanted to talk about Funfest. But the upcoming Final Fantasy 14 is coming out later this month. And Final Fantasy 15. I really look forward to 15. I love the series, love the games. They're really cool and all that. So I want to jump straight into this and start talking about Final Fantasy. Me and my brother started playing Final Fantasy 7. Yeah, that was the one that walked us into this big scale world. Where you can run around, do whatever you want to do. And so, that's how we were introduced. And then, it really took us a minute to beat it because, during school, we were in school at the time, I was about 14, maybe 12. And when we did beat it, we were very happy. Final Fantasy 8 came out. We were all worried. We gotta get this. We begged our dad to go. For our dad to don't get this game for us. We really wanna play. I remember staying up 24 hours playing and missing school just to beat this game. I'm not like, is there any game that I would do that to anymore? And the answer is yes. I would play every Final Fantasy in the school for. Now that I'm an adult, I really don't have the luxury, but it's like I can stay up hours and go, oh my god, I gotta go to work. I'm so tired, but I want to keep playing. Because that's what a gamer does, to keep on playing games. I'm starting to play some of the older Final Fantasies. I've been playing 4 on the DS. When it came out, I bought a DS. Like, oh, I want to get Final Fantasy 4. I want to get this. I played it. I don't think I beat it because somebody stole my DS for me. And, it really pissed me off, so I didn't really go get another one. But I remember it's the first game I played. I'm gonna go back. I'm going to play Final Fantasy 4. I'm getting it on my phone, so I know nobody's gonna take my phone, so I don't let anybody use my phone, so I know that I'm gonna be able to play. Right now, like I said, I'm playing number 5. I think I'm about in the halfway mark of it. It's a great game. I sit down and play it for hours, and it's just been fantastic to play this game. I love Final Fantasy games. I'm pretty sure that everybody likes Final Fantasy. If you don't like it, then you're missing out on great RPG playing games. One that I have a lot of people tell me is I need to play Final Fantasy 6 and the American put it as Final Fantasy 3 on the Super Nintendo. So I've been trying to keep my hands on a copy of Final Fantasy Mythology that has 5 and 6 together. Or I was just thinking of buying off my PlayStation, so I'm really looking to play that game. Because I heard Cascanoff, I don't know if I'm saying his name correctly. If you don't, please comment below, let me know if I'm mispronouncing his name. It's like one of the greatest ones to me. Sephiroth is the greatest villain of all time. But any game series I play, any games at all, This is the guy that he can look at you and say, I'm going to kill you, and I'm going to enjoy ripping your soul out of your chest. And I'm going to bathe in it. And I'm going to eat it. I'm going to enjoy it. I'm going to where he just gives off that very creepy feeling for a villain. To me, there is no better villain than Sephiroth. I met, like, watching this guy back in the sun with this smile. Like, this is a psychopath. Right here, this is a psychopath that you have to kill. I haven't been able to find a greater villain in any series that I played. You know, when I played Metal Gear Solid, you know, Lucas Snake kind of get up there, but you know, he is still way underset by the Cyclops. This is the person that he's seen this series now. He's gonna kill you. He's gonna betray you. And to me, that's creepy. You know, the creepiest villain I have ever played, and it just makes me love him more. I know that's part of Final Fantasy VII plus everything. I remember going to school and people dressing up like Sephiroth. That's the person that takes this game way too seriously. So, just do that. Yeah, I love Final Fantasy games. You know, I've been getting back into them lately. Maybe because I got nothing else on there in my time. I'm just like, you know, I want to play some Final Fantasy. Let's go get some Final Fantasy. Because right now, I don't have any Final Fantasy games, except for 5. I had 13, it got stolen. I have 13 too. My ex pawned it, and I never was able to get it out of the pawn, so I have to go back and buy it again. I beat 7, 8. I think I was at the end of line before somebody stole it out of my house. I beat 10. I didn't really care for 10 too that much. I think I got pretty much close to the end. If I didn't beat it, I at least got close to the main boss. The very last boss in the game. So I'm pretty good at making sure I get to the last boss. The same thing with the Final Fantasy 13. I think I got pretty damn close to that last boss. And then somebody took it out of my room or something. I don't know. I know they did some damage. So I'm going to slowly build up my confidence. I'm thinking about getting the first 4 on my phone and playing just right now. I can pay $16 for 3 of them, $8 for 1, and you know, hopefully I have enough room on my phone. Not get in a car, but in my home, I have more room. So I'm gonna really bust down and play this. I really want to get into and start playing more Final Fantasy. Well, yet, so for Final Fantasy, I'm putting it all over my room. It's like I don't live in a psychopath anymore. That I wouldn't really call it a psychopath. I call it a nut job, basically. That wouldn't allow me to do anything. Wouldn't allow me to go. It's like I was, you know, couldn't find this one by now. So now I can't. So I'm playing a bunch more Final Fantasies. The ones I haven't yet, I will get a better review. This is just an overload still on Final Fantasies that I haven't made personally. I heard people saying Final Fantasy 6 is one of the best Final Fantasy games. To me, 7 is my favorite. And then it goes to about 8, 13. I'm gonna get ready to buy the Final Fantasy 14 that's gonna be re-released again. So, excited to buy that. to see how that's going to be an online thing. So I always wanted to play 13, but I didn't have very good money back then. So now I do a lot better, so I buy more better stuff. So I'm really excited to see when 15 comes out and play the living shit out of it. What I have heard is an awesome. And it still revolves around crystals, but it's more like our world merged with the Lord of Five Things. You know, the monsters, the story, like, the characters. It's more driven. And I love that. I mean, you can't go wrong and go with that. Final Fantasy is hands down my favorite. My brother doesn't want to play Final Fantasy. He wants to play Final Fantasy. We used to play the shit out of it. We would fight over who was to be playing. Because what was that person got on? You say bye bye, you ain't gonna get a chance today. So we would be fighting over who was gonna play Final Fantasy. So to me, if you've never played Final Fantasy, you need to go and play it. It is a kick-ass game series. You know, I'm starting, I'm 26, I'm going back playing those ones that came out years ago. Final Fantasy's been out 26 years now. Final Fantasy started when I was just a baby in 1987. It's when the first Final Fantasy came out on the Super Nintendo. The Mega Bitcoin. For that time period, it was the core of RPGs game. Core of an adventure game. It blew everything up. It has, you know, literally changed what we know of, you know, game still. And still today, you know, they still try to push the envelope. Knowing that, you know, what we like and what we don't. I got used to the real-time, active, you know, play. You know, to me, it's really cool. When it was introduced in 12, I wasn't really a big fan of it. I'm like, you're taking the core of what we want to find fun things to be in turn-based. And then, you know, they started, you know, like, yeah, I like to run around with my enemies getting whacked me now. Where I can stand behind it and beat the living crap out of me, and there's no one there. So, you just have to let it build on you. But going from 1 to 9, 1 to 10, it's turn-based. It, you know, time meter. You attack, they attack, you attack, you attack, you smash it. They use something to try to kill your ass. You win, and it's really awesome. I know this video's got a little long, but I just love Final Fantasy so much that I really wanted to talk about it. I wanted to say, hey guys, here's a game, go out, buy it. Lately I've been doing book reviews, but I want to start trying to aim towards doing game reviews because I am a gamer by heart. Like my last review was on the Gone series, the first book, and as you can see, I'm still reading the second one, almost done, about, I think, 60 pages I got left. I should be done with that today. In a couple of days, I'll make a review on it. And then I'll probably go into the third book. But, you know, as right now, I love Infinity 5, so if you get a chance, you know, get on the PlayStation Network like I did. Or go find a friend that has a copy. This place will leave the shit out of it. So you will not be wrong. You know, fundamental stars, we have the job system. The job system of being a black mage, you know, knight, sorceress, summon. And you can take these job titles and move it towards other things. So you could be, you could do one master battle. And then you go into the summoner. And then you still can your team using the abilities that you learned from the previous job. So it's really cool. Really love it. And to me, Final Fantasy is the best game ever. Yeah, so go check it out. You know, comment below, tell me what your favorite Final Fantasy is. Tell me, you know, what games. I haven't played 1, 2, or 3, or 6. I played 4 for the DS. But I never finished playing it. So you can tell me which one's your favorite Final Fantasy. Why do you like Final Fantasy? Just comment below. Hit the subscribe button below. Leave a comment. Let me know. And as always, deuces. I'm your man, Julian, at KillBlondie.com. Check you guys later.